Alcock and Brown took off uphill, disappeared into the valley, slowly climbed out for 8 kilometers, made a turn back over the airfield, and proceeded through the Narrows over the Atlantic Ocean.
100 years ago, John Alcock and Arthur Brown made history by completing the first non-stop flight across the Atlantic Ocean. They took off from right here in St. John's, Newfoundland. Alcock and Brown's flight marked the beginning of a storied history that has put Newfoundland and Labrador on the world aviation map. From the flying boats of Botwood to Amelia Earhart's first solo female transatlantic flight, our history in aviation is exciting and impressive. Today, Newfoundland remains a vital player on the world's aviation stage. And it all began when Alcock and Brown left for Clifton, Ireland 100 years ago.
It's difficult to imagine what it was like 100 years ago because of all the build-up of houses and the like, but I think the skyline to the right and the hills there, I think I can remember seeing that in some of the photographs.
It was blown down over that hill.
It would have come down over there.
Over the Basilica.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
And out of the, over here.
And then gone that way.
Yeah, he was barely at 1,300 feet.
Yeah.
So that's at about 5, so he was up.
Yeah, probably about 800 feet above that.
Yeah, just about 800 feet above
Fantastic.
That.
Fantastic.
We have many airports that have many histories. Stephenville, Gander, Argentia, Harbor Grace, flying boats in Botwood. It's a huge part of aviation history.
Beginning in May 2019, we're hosting a series of events throughout the year with something for everyone. From our speaker series to an exciting downtown festival, from our historic stage production and summer garden party to our reception at St. John's City Hall and a commemorative flight. Then we'll cap it all off with a grand unveil of our commemorative statue in the summer of 2020.
The future of aviation in Newfoundland, I think, is very positive. I think it's growing. When you look at our instrument approaches here in St. John's alone, we have better instrument approaches than in our nation's capital. Airplanes will always fly into Newfoundland for fuel stops. Gander Centre is an essential communication point before crossing the Atlantic Ocean. It's only growing and it's going to get bigger.
For more information about our centennial celebrations, please join us at aviationhistorynl.com.